opportunity to get together once again for the 11th week of School of the Vision. And Lord, we thank you for once again, Johnny, preparing to train us for leading us into a mentorship anointing. And we ask, Lord, for your touch upon each one of us that have joined tonight. And Lord, thank you that we're finishing strong. And Lord, we rejoice in these past 11 weeks. And thank you for the teaching and the anointing that you've given John. And we just ask for your continued blessing upon him as he shares tonight.
Yes,
commit Lord. Our time to you now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. Amen.
You're on, John.
Who's got testimony of miracle this week?
I was catching an airplane from Philadelphia to Sarasota, and the plane from Philadelphia to Atlanta was late, and I thought I had 40 minutes. Turned out I had 10 minutes. So I asked the Lord to make the gate close by. I got off the one plane. four gates down was my plane.
Praise God.
I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
Get control over Delta as well.
Praise God. I was happy.
Well, that's still doesn't beat Mike Posterweight, who owns Delta Airlines.
I forgot that. Yes, that's right. He's one of those, what's it called? Diamond guy. He and Doug Woolley are diamonds.
Okay, now, Bill Shepherd. You got a miracle. You got several miracles.
Yes, sir. Let's just go with two. And I say that in love, and I say that with humility, because God's mercy endures forever. Amen. Well, let's start with Big Lots. Big Lots is a discount store. I don't know if you have it in your area. We were shopping. It was after 9. Robin was our cashier. And as we left, I gave Robin a bookmark and said, God bless you. I said, anyone in your family need prayer for sickness or illness? She said, yeah, me.
Wow.
She said, I have a right knee. I'm supposed to have surgery on that's in a lot of pain right now. And I have stomach problems and I have arthritic pain. So we prayed with her. Melissa will be in here in just a minute. Melissa and I had the honor of praying for her. And she said, she started looking for the pain and she said, wow, you know, 40 to 50% of the pain is actually gone. So, well, that's the start. You'll recover and you'll recover. So just recently we went to a Tulsa University event where a friend of mine had given a large donation to a computer lab. And as we were leaving, we stopped by a business and there was a homeless man there. He's actually security. He lives in his truck, named Harry. And Harry plays the guitar, oddly enough. We started singing and worshiping God. And I asked him if he would sing Waymaker. And he said, well, I don't know that song. Can you get me the chords? So Melissa pulls the chords up on her cell phone and Harry couldn't read it. And so we said, Harry, what's wrong? He said, it's my eyesight. I can't read this. I said, well, may we pray for you, sir? Harry said, please. And I began to pray for him that he would have 20/20 vision. And he said, I want better than 20/20 vision. No pressure, right? Okay. So anyway, we prayed with him. Now, I don't know if you can see this little bottle. This is one of those mini vitamin bottles. And the writing on the side of it's about like 3 or 4 agate, if you know what 8 agate is in newspaper. And so we handed him this, something like it. It was a B12. This is a D3, which is very good for you, by the way. But anyway, he read it without glasses. He read it and could read the small type.
Praise God.
Listen, I couldn't even read. Hallelujah.
Well, he asked for
thank
better.
You, Lord.
He got what he asked for. Praise God. He got better than 20/20, I guess. And then he could read the chords to play Waymaker. Hallelujah. On the smartphone. Great. Glory to God. Hallelujah to Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Yes, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Does anyone else have one?
Hi, John. Willard from Barbados.
Hi, Willard from Barbados, where the flying fish are eating for breakfast.
Yeah. Yes, I had a very good friend of mine. His wife was in the isolation center with COVID, very bad situation. And he called me and asked me to pray for her, and prayed for her, myself, and some of the guys from Full Gospel. And yesterday he called me and told me that she's fully recovered and she's back home.
Hallelujah.
Praise Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Hallelujah.
Who else?
I've got a quick one, guys. This afternoon, we were having a prayer meeting for my luncheon meeting for next week. So in a week in advance, we always get together on Zoom for the 1 hour prayer session. And there were seven of us on the meeting today. Roger was on there with us. And one of my friends, Vinny, came in. And Vinny's a member of Full Gospel. And he's been with us for about a year now. And we're talking to him and we're praying for him. And actually, his name's Louie. I got the name wrong. Louie is a brand new member, and we're praying for him. And I said, it just hit me at the end of the prayer session that he hadn't been baptized in the Holy Ghost. And I asked him, I said, Louie, would you like to receive the baptism in the Holy Ghost today? And right over Zoom, we had Larry D'Onofrio with us, and Roger, some of the full gospel men were praying right over Zoom. Louis received the Holy Ghost. About an hour later, I'm back here on my stair machine working out. My phone rings and it's Louis. He says, what happened at that luncheon meeting? It was beautiful. He was just bubbling. He felt the power of the Holy Ghost. And Roger had a scripture for him. It was Psalm 27.
27, yeah. Yeah.
It was like hitting a target with a dartboard. The Holy Ghost was moving. Did you say something, Roger?
I think we lost a connection.
Oh, but it was just a powerful prayer meeting, probably one of the best I've ever had. And it was a two hanky meeting. The Holy Ghost had the tears flowing.
Roger, you might want to reboot.
Yep.
You're frozen.
I think he's at his mother-in-law's.
Yeah, I'm doing it off of my iPhone as a hotspot. Am I unfrozen now? Can you hear me? Oh.
Okay.
Yeah. It's unstable.
It's winter time, so you're going to be frozen. It's winter.
That's why we're all wearing sweaters up here, right, Raj?
Yeah, I got my Under Armour thing on today.
Oh, but nothing like the baptism of the Holy Spirit, seeing a man just start to move in the Holy Ghost. And Louis is a blessing to our luncheon chapter up here, and I just can't wait to see him bloom like a flower. It's gonna be great.
And I just share this? So then I get in my car, and a friend of mine asked to speak to me, and he was the one. He's been on my heart, and I've been praying for him. The Lord's been guiding me very specific prayers, and he's at a point where he really needs to make some decisions in his life, and so he started sharing with me, and the Lord just started, and I'm driving, and I spoke to him for probably an hour and 15 minutes. And as we went, the Lord was just giving me scriptures and insight and words for him and everything else. And he was receiving, and he kept telling me, I got goosebumps. And then, so we had this incredible conversation. I didn't even know, I don't know how I got from Providence to Springfield. I just, all of a sudden, the car was pulling the driveway. But it closed by, I get a call from him about 5 minutes after I get in the house. And he said, I just got to tell you, my devotional that I was supposed to read yesterday, I didn't read. So I read it just now after I got off the phone. I was still feeling the Holy Spirit. And he read it to me. And it was an exact confirmation of our conversation. And he just said, I almost dropped my book. So it's just it was a great good day today, really. And he's one of the people that when I prayed in tongues and got him on my heart.
Thank you, Jesus. That's great. Any more?
Hello, this is Carol.
Hi, Carol.
McKenzie. Hello. Hello, everyone. Uncle Dan was in a coma, totally swollen, and prayed for him. His niece went to Chicago to be with him, and they expected that he would die that day, but he got out of his coma and received the Lord as his savior. And a few days after, he went home to be with the Lord. And then there was another young lady who I prayed for. She had swelling in the neck and a lot of pain over the weekend. And now she's fine. The swelling is gone and the pain. Glory to God.
Amen. Keep up the good work. Jesus gets all excited when he can use you for those things.
Amen. Yeah, I just want to thank God for his grace over me and my family. Last week, I traveled to Nigeria to bury my dad. My dad was 100 years old, you know. Wow. So that was a great, that's one of the testimonies for him to live that long. One of the things that, one thing again I was able to do during the burial, I was able to share the Voice magazine, which I got from Bob Nations, and at least a lot of people there in the village were just like, give it to me, and you know, that was a great opportunity. One thing happened while we were there. We were scheduled to come back to the to leave for back to the United States last Saturday, somewhere along the line, my wife got a call that she needed to get back to the office immediately. Now, I don't know if you guys can understand, you know, being all the way there. So I made a call to Delta. That was like about 1 a.m. Nigerian time. And I called them and I said, hey, I need to get back to the United States immediately ASAP. So to God be the glory, we're able to get a flight immediately. That's day, that is, on the 24th. And we left and got back to the United States on the 25th. Now, the greatest testimony about this is that now we're supposed to unfailingly get back to work on Monday. But do you know that our flight that we're supposed to leave Abuja on Saturday, that flight was delayed. And it was so much delayed that if we hadn't gotten out of Nigeria, you know, early, we would have had so much issues, you know, with work and all that. So I just want to give God the glory for him to be able to arrange that we left on time. And, you know, we were saved the, you know, the issues of work and all that. And the Lord took us to Nigeria and brought us back to the United States. To him be all the glory. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. We're so appreciative you're with us right now. So thank you for tuning in. Where is the Dixon family from? Michael Dixon.
Good night. So sorry. My phone is off. I was just closing a call. I am in Atlanta, Georgia, but I'm originally from Jamaica.
Wonderful.
Yes.
Great. We're looking to start some ladies' chapters in Atlanta, Georgia, real soon.
I saw the email concerning that.
Oh, great. Mike is hard at work, I can tell.
Yeah.
Okay, you all. I love the way that you're allowing Jesus to do miracles through you. I always like to shake people up by saying, you and me have never done any miracles, but Christ in us has done a bunch.
Amen.
And he's hard at work. If we'll just let him, if we'll just give him free rein, let him have the freedom to love people through us and to minister through us, you'll be just like the early disciples that Jesus trained. Just let him live through you. Isn't that wonderful? We have a really important class tonight, because after we've taught this class in over 30 nations around the world, we realized that people would graduate out of this class totally different than their fellow members of Full Gospel Businessmen and of their churches, because the members that went through the School of the Vision came out understanding that Christ was in them and he was doing the miracles. And people that had been in chapters that had not gone through the school were reflecting what their churches had taught them over the years. And usually that's almost Old Testament teaching. And they're saying you have to love more, but love doesn't originate with us. It originates from Jesus through the Holy Spirit. And so this for some people is a new concept, to allow the fruit of the Spirit to flow through us when we're born again. And I would encourage all of you to check the members in your classes, in your chapters, to see, just make sure that everyone is born again, because life in the Spirit begins with a born again experience. And to think of it, in 1981, Demas had an encounter with the Heavenly Father. Demas asked him, when are you going to send the end time revival that is going to prepare the churches of the body of Christ to bring in the great harvest? And the Father, this is written in the book Intensified Vision. The Father said, I'm waiting on you. I've given you my Son. I've given you his name. I've given you his authority, and I can't give you anything else. For that end time revival to come in, to bring in the end time harvest, you're going to have to take what I've given you and go with it, and go and do. Well, as I read those words, I could only think of an investor, that any one of you can invest in the stock market here in the USA and expect a return on your money. Jesus talked about an investor that wanted a return on his money. It's the story of the rich young ruler that went to receive a commission and went out of the country, and he called three of his trusted servants, and he gave each one some money, and he said, you work with this money as you think right, and when I come back, I'll ask you for, in other words, for the profit, the dividends. And so when he came back, the one that he had given five coins to said, I invested it, and here are five more. I got five more. And his boss was so happy with him. He said, wonderful, that's great. And then the next one who he gave, I think
three.
Thank you. Three. Yeah, you get an A in this course. And he says, what did you do? Well, I did the same thing. I invested and I got three back. He says, wonderful, that's great. So he went to the third one, and someone else here can tell you better than I can. That guy said, I was fearful that I was going to lose it, so I went out and buried it. And here it is, the one coin. And you remember the story. The owner got all mad at this guy, took that coin away from him. And who did he give it to? He gave it to the one that had five coins and had gone out and got more. So when the Heavenly Father was talking to Demas, he was like that investor. He says, I've given you my son. I've given you his name. I've given you his authority. I can't give you anything else. But I'm waiting on you. And that was the reason Demas wrote the book about the intensified vision. Because the father was looking at this as an investment of his son in the body of Christ. And unfortunately, when he came to look for profit, most of the people were still asking Jesus to be their servant. Heal my family, heal my money, heal my body, do this miracle, do the other miracle. They were asking him to do things for them, but they had not learned to allow Jesus to do things for others through them. And that's the whole story behind the School of the Vision, is to help our members go from being requesters, Jesus, and only see him as a savior, and who says, come unto me and I will give you rest. And begin to see Jesus as Lord. It says, follow me. And when we follow him, we follow in his footsteps, doing the same exact things that he did, because Christ is in us. Now see, most of the churches do not ever teach or preach about Christ being in us. They're saying, come, get saved, get saved, get saved. Every weekend, they're saying to those that are already saved to get resaved, so to speak. I know that's how it was in my church for the last 10 years. And just recently, my pastor has been talking about Christ in you, and his whole perspective has changed. Well, if Christ in you is, that means he can do miracles through you. And what's the key? It's being connected. Connected prophetically, connected obediently, being able to hear what he wants to do through you and doing it. That means investing what he's given us to get a return on. So this is going to be the big change. It's a transformation that I believe is happening right now as we speak in the world, around the world. There's a transformation coming on the body of Christ. And it's the transformation is that Christ is being revealed in Christians. It's always been that way. You can't be a Christian without Christ in you. It's just impossible. You can be a believer. You can believe in God, but that doesn't mean you're going to heaven. That doesn't mean you're saved. To be a Christian, you've got to be born again. And that's why I said, go back to your chapters and ask the people point blank, is there anyone here that is unsure of their born again experience? And if you say it in a nice way, the people will have confidence to raise their hand and say, well, I just don't really explain. I know one's that really explained it to me. And at that moment, you can lead them in that born again experience and they can be sure of their salvation, but they can be sure that Christ lives within them, and they can be excited that Christ in them not only is going to do miracles through them, but he's going to bring the fruit through them. And he's going to actually love their, they're going to love their enemies. Well, maybe they won't, but Christ in them will love their enemies, and they'll just give up and say, okay, I will too. They'll have peace like never, never known before. They'll have joy for no apparent reason. This is Christ in our members is, it changes them from other people that sit in the benches of churches and have not had that experience. Plus, Jesus in them does the miracles, but he needs us to, here's the word. This is a new word that is used in business these days. It's called collaborate. Collaboration is a big word in business. It's, I have programs on my computer that are set up specifically so that I can collaborate with someone in another nation. And I can type in there and the people in the other nation can be reading what I'm typing at that moment and comment on it. It's collaboration. Well, that's the same way that Jesus wants to work with us. He wants us to collaborate with him. And when we pray in tongues in the morning and get the interpretation, then that interpretation brings the revelation of who Jesus wants to touch that day. And when we receive the interpretation of what God wants to do, we can be sure that that miracle is going to come to pass because it's him that's doing it. We're just collaborating with him. We're laying hands on so that Jesus can flow through us and do the miracle in another person. So this is a transformation that's going on right now. And believe me or not, Demas knew that full gospel businessman was to be a catalyst for this time in history, a catalyst to bring these truths to the body of Christ so the body of Christ can be prepared to work, to collaborate with Jesus, bringing in the end time harvest. One of the things that Demas wrote in Intensified Vision in the introduction, he says, God is looking for a people that is prepared to serve him in power. Well, that's the basis of this school. The school is not here to force feed anybody with information. No, it's to bring you into a relationship with the Holy Spirit, with Jesus and the Holy Spirit, so that Jesus can communicate with you through the Holy Spirit and you can get the work done through the Holy Spirit that Jesus wants to do. So it's Jesus informing us what he wants to do and empowering us by the Holy Spirit to do what he wants to do. He'll do it through you. So last week, we were doing this exact school in Southern Africa. It's centered in Zambia. And there was a lady from Zambia that asked for prayer for her daughter. Her daughter was going to South Africa for an athletic event where she runs as a high school student in this athletic event in South Africa. But a week before she was to leave, she had great pains in her foot and in her leg. And when she complained to her coaches, they said, well, you can't run. You can't go on this trip. So you just stay here and get healed up and you can go on the next trip. Well, the mother comes to the school. And so she asked for prayer for the daughter. And we just sort of marked that down and went on to other things without praying for her. But at the end, when we were about ready to close the school, the Lord reminded us to pray for the daughter. So we did. We spoke healing over that girl's leg and foot. And I got a text today that the girl was absolutely healed. She went to her coaches and said, try me out. I'm good. And had to run around and do flexes, whatever. And she was totally healed. They said, you're on the plane going to South Africa. So they expected her to bring back medals, they told her. That's the way this works. We learn from Jesus where there's a connection with the Holy Spirit. See, when we're born again, the Holy Spirit is one that comes in and sets up like a place for Jesus to live in us. And that's Jesus then begins to express himself through us so that he can continue his mission in the earth that he started 2,000 years ago today through us. You can do it. And that's just the most exciting thing, like was said here tonight, when miracles happen through your hands and you didn't have anything to do with it. You were just responsive to the revelation that Jesus gave you through the Holy Spirit. And that makes you walking in the Spirit. You will not fulfill the lusts of the flesh when that happens. It's a wonderful way that God has put all this together. And to do that, a few months ago, we discovered that in all these countries where we've, over 30 countries that we've been teaching this School of the Vision, that there's a big problem. And the Lord spoke to me clearly, just as clear and loud as I'm talking to you right now. He said, the School of Vision can train and equip the students, but it will be the leaders of chapters and nations who will cause the intensified vision to take root in a chapter or in a nation. In other words, it's the leaders that need to know how to help the graduates of this school begin to do the things that Jesus asked them to do. So we put together a 5-class course for leaders of chapters and nations. So there are certain things, how to run a chapter, that will allow the Holy Spirit to guide the individual member. We don't want to guide a chapter, but we want to set the members free so that they can obey the Lord Jesus Christ. For instance, for years, maybe 20 years, maybe more, in Latin America, when anyone would come to his chapter, he would be given a piece of paper. And on that piece of paper, he is expected to write down what were the prayer requests that he needed. And so some of these people would come only to fill out that paper and leave, because the Lord was answering those prayer requests all over Latin America. I don't know how this thing got started, but I'll venture to say that they began to write out their prayer requests directly to God because no one had the courage to lay hands on the sick and command healing to go into people's lives. So it was a fallback strategy that we had, and it was spread all over Latin America. Well, we discovered that, you know, this great that the Father will do all these miracles for us, but the membership is unprepared to minister. If someone asks them to pray for a sick person, they'll say, get me a piece of paper. And they'll fill out the piece of paper with that. And then they'll have to look around for someone taking an offering, because that's where the prayer requests were put, in the offering basket. And those prayer requests were just thrown in with a prayer for finances and for the offering that was received that day. Even so, God did tons and tons of miracles. But we've noticed when the students of the school begin to believe that Jesus is in them and begin to receive the revelation of what he wants to do, then those miracles get answered also. And he rejoices that we're allowing him to express himself through us and not just write him letters. In other words, members who actually pray for people in Jesus' name are able to see the same miracles than those people that were writing out petitions, because Christ is literally inside them. There were two girls that came up. One of them was blind in one eye. One was losing her sight in the other eye. And her younger sister brought this blind girl up and said, please pray for her. And so we did. We laid hands on her eyes and commanded healing in the name of Jesus, and that the blindness, the spirit of blindness, would leave now in Jesus' name. And the younger looked in the face of the older and said, can you see? Can you see? And she says, I don't know. I have to cover up my good eye. And the Holy Spirit, one of our men, just could not wait. He stuck out his hand and covered up the good eye. And she screamed because the eye that was blind was now 20/20. It was, and so this girl's life was totally changed, and she went away and was a different person, because God had come into her life in a violent way and turned around what the devil had tried to steal from her. So this is what Jesus really wants. He wants us to be useful to the Father in these days. So that was the beginning of the school, literally. The school, that's how the school started. Because Demas Shakarian wrote, God is seeking a people who have been prepared to serve him with power. Well, my goodness, there were some nations that had their own little weekend training. But the problem was, now listen to me, if you're a leader in a chapter, this is for you. The problem was that these people that were trained in the equivalent of an ALTS seminar, Advanced Leadership Training Seminar, would come down from that weekend training and come back into a cold chapter, where they were still writing out their prayer requests on papers. And so the man that had gone out and gotten on fire, within 2 or 3 months was just as cold as the chapter was. And when the Lord spoke to me and he said, it's the leaders that will implement, that's the word I was looking for, implement the intensified vision, then I realized there was a need for a training for leaders. So then there was another requirement, and that was for mentors. Now, what the heck is a mentor? Jesus was a mentor. They called him a teacher. A mentor is someone that is available 24/7 for a student to call and ask for guidance. I'd ask for direction, for a prayer partner, for someone to inform them of the truth. And so we're starting, when is that date that we're starting on that, Bill?
January 5th, same time.
Okay, and it's 5 classes. So unless something changes, there'll be 5 weeks, one class a week, but that'll give you all week to practice what you learn in class. So it's not 5 classes, it's 5 weeks of classes. And what is important about becoming a mentor? For you to be able to teach this school for 12 weeks, you've got to show that you receive the same revelation Dima Shakarian received. You don't have to see the vision, but you've got to be aware what he was looking at. And what he was looking at the body of Christ that had their hands in chains. They were frozen. They had no relationship to the guy next to them. And they were unavailable to God. That's the majority of the body of Christ today, is unavailable to God. And so if he's counting on the body of Christ to bring in the end time harvest, he's going to have to make some changes so that we can be useful to him. And so that's one of the purposes he raised up the school, to bring forth that revelation that has been hidden. It's a mystery. Even Paul said it was a mystery. My goodness. Wow. And he says it's a mystery that's been hid from ages, but is now revealed to the saints, or now revealed to the apostles, or whatever it is. It's revealed to you now. The Christ in you, the hope of glory. And what is glory in that? I found that word glory again in John chapter 17, where Jesus was talking to his Father. And he said, the glory you've given me, Father, I've given it to them. Who is them? Well, it's all of you guys that are looking at me right now. He gave you the glory. And the I'm sorry, forgive me. The glory is what makes you one with God. Wow, you're not just a Sunday Christian. You're not just a how can I say this any better? You're Christ inhabits, indwells you. He lives through you if you will give him the freedom for the Holy Spirit to do it. Now, I've been a Christian many years. And one day the Lord said to me, I can't use you anymore. And I said, what? He said, yeah, you're stubborn. I said, what's that got to do with it? Stubborn people always want their way. Stubborn people want to be king, want to be Lord, even of the Lord himself. Oh, no, it can't be that bad. And my wife said, yeah, it's that bad. So I had to come to Jesus. What do you call it? You know, it's one of those moments where you learn that you have to crucify your old man, because that old man is a filthy dude. And it's an offense to say, no, Lord, let's do it this way. When all he's looking for you, it to say, yes, Lord. Whatever the Holy Spirit puts into you, yes, Lord. And I told you that a couple of weeks ago, that this man that was fired in Zambia by this foreign company that was there. They wiped out the whole board of directors. They were unhappy. I'm unhappy with them. But this one guy that the Lord had inspired our national president there to pray for him, he was rehired and made CEO, chief executive officer of that company. And he's there today. So you and I become people that change the destiny of nations. In Zambia, they just had some elections and they have a new chief justice who is an honorable man. And they're so excited about that. And so I'm not kidding you. It's the Christians in a nation, the born again Christians in a nation that govern the nation. Because without the Christians governing the nation, the kingdom of darkness takes advantage of all the nation and spends its money and sends people off in useless wars and all kinds of things that they're not led by wisdom. So this is so important that you be in connection with what Jesus says by the Holy Ghost and obey and do what he says, at least the first step. Just take the first step and Jesus, and then you get a tailwind of the Holy Spirit. He's like, he opens doors for you and pushes you in the right direction. And it's wonderful. Now, let me tell you how this mentor class will work. It's based on 2 Timothy 2:2. Now, isn't that hard to memorize? Even I can memorize that. 2 Timothy 2:2. It says, things that you have heard from me, Paul said, pass it on to faithful men that can teach others. And so, you know, once in next week, once we close this school down, what's going to happen? Is it going to be replaced? Or are people to replace it going to base their teaching on what God revealed to Demas Shakarian? Or what? And so this is why I want you to know that if you feel led to be a trainer, to teach this school, we need about 10 people to train people in this school. And how do you know if you're called to be a teacher or not? Well, come to the school, sign up, and you'll find out real soon, because you're going to receive not only training, but homework to find out if this is a calling that God is putting on your life or not. I didn't discover that this was my calling until I got to be past 70 years old. And then I look back and my father was a teacher. My mother was a teacher. One of my sons is a teacher. And my aunt was a teacher. It's all through my DNA. And I said, wow, John, you were pretty much useless to God all these years. You better ask for a bunch of mercy and grace, because if not, you're screwed. So I just want you guys to be the happiest people on earth. Listen to me. You know this better than I do. Are those that have discovered their God's calling for their life, and regardless of what's happening in the world around them, they're doing it. Okay, let me ask you an honest question. How many members in your chapter have discovered God's calling for their life? Or are they just coming to the chapter meetings to enjoy, and they're charging up their batteries? So your leaders, And I'm talking a little strong right now to your leaders, but I have to do this. I say, are you going to follow what God revealed to Demas Shakarian? Or are you going to follow what you've been doing the last 20 years? And if you're hoping to get the same results, one of the things that a mentor needs to have received, and you don't have to receive this going into the school, this is what those five classes will teach you. The original one and the intensified two visions. It's the same vision, but one is shifted into second gear light and is going faster. The difference between the original vision and the intensified vision is that Christ in you is in the intensified vision. He's implementing his own vision through you, but you got to be useful to him. You got to be collaborating with him. You got to be working with him. You got to give him permission to tell you what to do, and you've got to respond to it. Every member in every chapter, we need to assure ourselves. See, if we're going to be faithful leaders, every member is born again. Now, I've been on tons of nations where FGBMFI has them. And when I began to ask questions, who's really received the born again experience? Well, they all start off by raising half of them raise their hands because they don't, usually they work off the term saved. If I'd say, how many are saved? Everyone would raise their hand. But when I say, how many are born again? Maybe only half of them would raise their hand. And then I say, well, how do you know you're born again? And then a lot of people keep real quiet. They don't know. Well, when you're born again, you'll begin to see the fruit immediately in your life. Love, joy, peace. You'll get along with your enemies. Because Jesus in you loves your enemies. You'll have more faith. Up to now, you've just had belief or something like that. But faith is a spiritual fruit and a spiritual gift. You have faith by the Spirit of God. That's the difference. And so these things, you begin to learn not only the gifts of the Spirit, but the fruit of the Spirit and how to walk in the Spirit and not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. How to receive the gift of tongues and interpretation in tongues. And how to minister healing and deliverance and prophecy and salvation. All these things are in that school. So that when you come out of that school, you can teach these things to the members that are in the school of the vision, the 12-week school of the vision. You can send people away that have been prepared to serve the Lord with power. Now, those who are mentors can also teach in the leaders. That's a 5-week or a 5-class course also. And that is how to run a chapter. Studying to get into politics. It goes into the mechanics of running a chapter so that the members are trained to go home every day and to see miracles in their lives. Now, the way it used to work in the past, most of our members, and I'm talking about the USA, I'm talking about Europe, I'm talking about Latin America, most of our, there was a time when our chapters wouldn't even meet weekly. They would meet maybe once a month. And I don't know if you attended a church that met once a month, do you think that would impact that city very much? So it's like when you meet weekly in your chapters, you're building an army. You're building a group of men and women that are able to go out and confront Satan right where he is in the lives of other people and kick him out in Jesus' name and bring those people into the chapter so that they can be trained also and sent back out to do the works of Christ. The same works of Christ that he did, Christ in them will be doing the same works. So I want to encourage you. We've come up to the end of the hour now. And I want to encourage you. I'm going to ask you to pray for this. Because if we don't have mentors or teachers that have received the same revelation that Demas Shakarian received, the same truth that Christ is in you, will continue to be flatline, unusable to God. But I'm believing, and there's proof of this already, that God has chosen a work in the USA and in the Caribbean, Willard, you can't turn it back. Because the time, we're at the end time. And he'll raise up people. If you just give them room and let them and invite them in, he'll raise up men and women that will be discipled. I'm going to ask everyone to say this word with me. Are you ready? Turn on your mics. I don't know if you want to say this word. It's a tough word. Disciple.
Disciple. Disciple.
I don't know. Can you be a businessman and a disciple at the same time? Yeah, just read Doug Woolley's book. Yes, yes, you can be a disciple.
Amen.
You can Amen. Know God's calling for your life.
Amen.
And you can Amen. Do God's calling in your life and you'll be the happiest.
Hallelujah. Amen.
So this is my prayer for you. Father, I ask that you reveal to every one of my brothers and sisters.
Yes, Lord.
Who are those that you have called to be mentors and teachers and disciples, to be disciples of Christ? Oh, I worship you. I exalt you. Thank you. For you have started something in the earth, Lord, that cannot be turned back. And I thank you and I praise you, Lord. That as we look around us, you're quickening the body of Christ to be useful to you in the end time harvest. We're there now. We thank you for it, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. That's Amen. The reason. That's the reason why we studied Tommy Hicks's dream. I think it was last week, because. There's a transformation happening to the body of Christ. That sleeping giant is awakening now. It's been under the weight of demons and sin for centuries. But God now is setting us free. I don't know how he's doing it, but he's setting us free. And that giant is going to literally rise up, and God is going to multiply it by the thousands all over the world. God told Demas that he wanted a fellowship with 1 million members. And I wouldn't be surprised that that's where it's coming from that sleeping giant that is awakened and being transformed into millions of little giants, every one of them anointed by the power of God to go through the earth, bringing people to Jesus. Okay, Bill, I'm all done.
All right. Thank you, John. I know we all appreciate it. Just as we've done the last 10 classes, let's go ahead and take a minute and pray in